Rabotai, we would like to bring out a concept today, Bezrat Hashem Balaneder. What's the Peshat when it says in the Mishnah Ediyot in Perek Hey Mishnah Vav, Mutov la'adam shikre shoteh kol yomav, it is better that a person be called a shoteh all the days of his life, ve'al ye rasha sha'a achad lefnei makom. But he shouldn't be chas v'shalom, a rasha, a wicked person, even for one moment in front of Hashem. So Rabbi, so we did this piece of Gibor maybe last year, even a few months ago, I'm not even sure. But as I was doing it today again, I heard a rabbi say a beautiful pshat in it, which I didn't even pay attention in the Gemara. That's the secret of learning. When you learn again and again the same thing, always something new comes up. So we want to speak about Rav Amr Chassida when he had all the captive women in his house. And then he tried to pick up the ladder. I just want to tell you the story and what this has to do. I want to try to connect it. The Gemara says, Masechet Kiddushin Daf Pei Aleph Amr Aleph, Hanech Shavuya Shavuta Da'atil in Nahardia. These captive women that they came to Nahardia, Askinu Libei Rav Amram Chassida, they brought them up to the house of Rav Amram Chassida. Askuli Darga Mikamei, Rabotai, you have to understand. They took all these captive beautiful women. They didn't know where to leave them. They didn't know who to trust them with. So who are you going to find better than a rabbi? They found Rav Amr Chassida. They said he has an attic. We're going to put him in the attic. And there was a ladder that was going up. When they brought all the women into the attic, they put him there. The Gemara says, then the ladder was removed so the woman don't run away or nobody goes up there. Behadi tika chafa chadi minayhu. Rabotai, in the middle of the night, one of the women passed by the attic, by the entrance. She passed. Nafal Nuhura Befume. A certain light, the beauty that she was so beautiful that there was like a metaphorical way of saying the beauty attracted like him. There was light in the whole house. He caught a glimpse of her. Shakli Rav Amr Lidarga. Rav Amr took the staircase, the ladder. Dulohava Yachlim Be Astral Midalei. You needed 10 people to pick it up. 10 people couldn't pick it up. He himself, an old guy, he took it. Dalei lechudi, he took it by himself. Salik ve'azel. Now he started going up. He started going up the ladder. Kimate lepaga darga. When he came to halfway of the ladder, he realized what he's doing because the Gemara Rashi says he wanted to go do the aver with the woman because once a woman chasam catches a guy, once the yitzhar catches you, shalom aliso, you can start saying kaddish for him, rabotai. If sheikh, what did Rav Amr Chassida do? He took his thighs and he started pushing against the ladder so he shouldn't be able to continue going up because the Yitzhar wants to go up, but he doesn't want to do it. He realized that this is wrong. Rama Kali Nura Be Amr, he started screaming. There is a fire in Rav Amr's house. There is a fire in Rav Amr's house. And you have to understand, when you say there's a fire in somebody's house, all his students, all the neighbors, Rashi says, they took buckets of water running into the house, now wanting to what? To put out the fire. Atu Rabbanan, the students, the rabbis came, meaning students came. Amru le Rabbi said, listen to this. This is the Chiddush. They said to him, Kasfitinan, you embarrassed us. Rav Amr Chassida, we are your students. We learn by you. We speak about you. You sit there and you tell us, Shmirit, and Naim, you can't do this. And here you are, you're going to do the Avera. You embarrassed us. Rabotai, listen to this. Amr lehu Rabotai, Rav Amr Chassida told the Talmidim, Mutav is better. Tichsafu be amr be amahadin. It's better that I should be embarrassed in this world. Velo tichsafu minei da amr da atei. Rabotai, and I should not be embarrassed in the next world. It is better that you know my embarrassment now in this world than to chas v'shalom come to the next one. Then you're going to know the truth about me. Rabotai, what is the Gemara? What's the pesach in the Gemara? Rabotai, say. He listened to the shab. I forgot his name. Rabotai, he said like this. How many of us, Rabotai, are willing to take that shame to do the right thing? We start thinking, my friend, my mother, my father, we start making all the cheshbonot. But how many of us say, you know something, it's not about me, it's about Hashem. Even if I'm going to be embarrassed, it doesn't mean anything because I want to do what's right. It's better that a person be embarrassed in this world than to chas v'shalom be embarrassed in the next world. And that's why the Chafetz Chaim brings down that it's better for a person to be a shoteh all the days of his life and not to chas v'shalom be a rasha one moment before Hashem. Now guys, I'm not going to go through everything that I usually say, but it's very simple. How many of us, I'll be honest with you, how many people call? What do you get out of learning? What do you sit there? The, you know, this, that. What's that's it, you learn. What's after? Rabotai, you missed the boat. The learning in itself is the excitement. There's nothing more great than learning. You could put all the pleasures of the world, like Chazal tell us, on one scale and put one aleph. Forget about the aleph. The crowns that go on the aleph on the other scale is going to outweigh it. All this that you see to people having all the good times of their life, it's all stuyot. There's nothing there. I'm telling you, there's nothing there. Why? What's the proof? How many people are doing it and in the end they die out of drugs, they get divorced, the wife will take half if not more of what they own. Rabotai, if you're so happy, why are you getting divorced? Why you have so many problems? Why are you on drugs? Rabotai, the proof is nothing will make you more happy in the world than learning Torah. Therefore, we have to try to see, guys, we have to try to take. This is the problem today. Somebody tells you one thing, yeah, somebody wants to do something not right, right? We're always afraid to say, no, I can't come. I'm not coming. Nicely. I can't do it. But you just, you know how the people say, but my, we're family. You have to respect. Derech Eretz Kadmal. That's all they know, Rabotai. Derech Eretz Kadmal Torah. That's all they know. What Derech Eretz Kadmal Torah, Rabotai? What happens to the Derech Eretz between you and Hashem first? But that's where we have our problem. We always think that people come before Hashem. It's just the opposite, Rabotai. Hashem comes before people, not people before Hashem. That's the people think it's okay to do X, Y, and Z. I'm not going to go through all the things. Rabotai, let's learn from Rav Amr Chassidah. It is better to be embarrassed in this world than to Chas V'Shalom be embarrassed in the next world. Because you know why? To be embarrassed in the next world, Chas V'Shalom, Rabotai, the embarrassment is not 1 minute or 2 months or 3 months that they talk about you over here. Right? When you have something news, it dies down after 2 weeks, 3 weeks, whatever, a month. Rabotai, over there, the embarrassment, you know how long it stays for? How long? Netzach and Netzach for eternity. Who's going to see it? Your grand-grandmother, older, everybody's going to be able to see if you don't do teshuva, Rabotai. That's what Rabotai, Bezrat Hashem, we should always take this into consideration. If we want to do Nevera, and I'll tell you something, a lot of times it happens, you have people say, why do you have to get up early? Why do you have to learn Torah? Why do you have to go to shul? Do this, come, have fun, do this. Rabotai, you don't have to listen, but yeah, you're not going to look so respectable in their eyes. Besides the Rabotai, you'd rather be respectable in the eyes of Hashem. But the honest truth is, when you do what Hashem wants, even your enemies will bow down to you. Baruch Adonai L'Olam, Amen v'Amen.